this is definitely the place. A4, Great West Road. It's around here somewhere. Is this a gym? Hello. Oh, look at this. Impressive. Hi, Zhou.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
You're good?
Nice place. Nice place you got here. Do your days off always start with a gym session?
Unfortunately, yes.
Okay, unfortunately, yeah. Well, look, I've got my gym kit. So I want you to train me like a Formula One driver.
Yeah, sure. Oh,
all right,
good.
I'll get a change.
Come on, Joe.
That's 35, 38, yes, 40 kilos. Come on.
Okay. That was good effort.
That was good.
What have I got?
32.
32?
32.9, yeah.
It's not so bad. Thanks very much. The workout.
Enjoy the session.
It's good.
You will enjoy more tomorrow morning though.
Will I?
Yeah.
Okay. Right, so thanks for that. Yeah. What else do you like to do on a day off then?
As you know, I love fashion. So I like to go to shops, go shopping in town, just finding some cool stuff. So.
All right. Okay, well, a trip into town. I've got the perfect vehicle for you.
That's really cool.
Nice.
Spider.
It's maybe not as fast as your Alfa Romeo, but just as cool.
Yeah, I like it. It's
good. Do you want to drive?
You can drive it.
I'll drive it. All right.
Very easy.
Let's go.
Very good.
So what was it about Spain? Obviously, we come to Montreal off Spain. Your best result of the season equal with Melbourne.
Yeah, the start opening lap was really good. I think one of the best I did, getting four positions.
What was particularly impressive for me about Spain was that there was no drama.
No, there was.
You were there purely on
the pace.
Purely on pace.
I was really happy for
yeah,
that.
Yeah, I'm sure you were.
We are P9.
Let's go, guys. Let's go.
Whoop, just popped out a second there.
I think we are here.
Ah, I need that gym strength.
Is there no, there's no power steering?
No, there's no power steering. Thank you. Good. The Alpha.
Yeah.
She got us there. To be honest, I need a bit of help. So you're going to style me.
Yeah. Okay. This is a nice store, you know.
Oh, well, very nice. Listen, my propensity is for shorts and sandals. So, Joe, I'm clearly a guy who needs help. If you weren't a racing driver, would you like to work in fashion?
Yeah, I do actually. You know, the outfits I come to the track on Thursday, it's not by any clothes set or anything picked. It's all just by myself that I pick. I feel like this is the real me, and yeah, these are nice, aren't they?
Nice one, peep.
These purple ones.
Look at these magnificent trousers.
This is cool, huh? That's more like it.
I feel magnificent. Am I wearing it right?
Yes, it suits you.
Sold.
Looks like me, we can walk together now on Thursday when we arrive on the paddock. So.
What are you doing? Oh, two. All right.
Feels so good. You have no idea how it feels.
Well, after all that shopping, it's lunch. So this is the way you you get on your. I tell you, your days off are pretty action packed. I'm loving it so far.
Yeah.
What do we do at the What do we do at the hot pot?
Hot pot. Many of you know is my favorite like kind of Chinese dish.
It's quite actually people might not realize there's quite a healthy karting scene in Shanghai.
Yeah, I mean, I won basically everything that was possible in China.
Yeah.
So, you know, very young age, and yeah, I decided to move to UK
and to Sheffield. So what was the reason you settled there?
Yeah.
As a what, 11-year-old, 12-year-old?
Yeah, 11 years old.
Wow. You were at a secondary school there and you did your GCSEs?
Yeah, I got 1A as well.
Oh, good.
But A+, because it's Chinese, the exam, it took like 40 minutes.
Right.
I did it like within 10 minutes.
Yeah, I'm not surprised.
Yeah, they was like, are you sure you finished? I was like, yeah, and I got A-stars.
And before you could do A-levels or college or something like that, you were off into Formula 4 and Formula 3.
Yeah, that was that was another huge step, let's say, in terms of my career, because I was able to get picked by obviously the Driver Academy or Ferrari, and it was a really good step, you know.
But listen, what I do know about China and Chinese sports, and you look at their success at the Olympics, is that they like winners.
For people in China, we like to just victories, but now I think they're really proud of me, and once they starting understand really about what Formula One really is, and should be the only one represent my home, I think yes, it's something really great honor.
All right, well listen, thank you so much. Xie xie.
Xie xie xie.
Is that right?
Yeah, that's
good. I got
correct.
The pronunciation?
Yeah, that's good.
Excellent. Good.
Thank you.
Thank you.